Hello and welcome back. This is Rituraj and I hope you are doing absolutely fantastic in your life. So continuing our discussion about reinforcement learning, today in this video we are going to talk about something called Monte Carlo approach in reinforcement learning. So in our previous video, when we talked about policy iteration and value iteration, we assumed that the agent knows everything about the environment. That means the agent has access to the model of the environment. It knows the transition dynamics. That is, the agent knows the consequences of the actions it takes in the environment. For example, it knows what are the possible states it might go after applying an action in a particular state. Well, this is a very strong assumption because in real world, let's say a robot may not have complete information about the environment. So we need some approach where the agent doesn't need to know about the environment and it knows about the environment after interacting with the environment. And accordingly, it can learn a policy to solve a particular task in the environment. In our previous discussion about policy iteration and value iteration, the agent uses the model of the environment and accordingly plans a policy to solve a particular task in the environment. So it doesn't try anything in the environment. It has the model of the environment, so it knows what are the dynamics, how it will move from one state to another depending upon the action. So it can plan something inside its head and accordingly come up with a policy to solve a particular task. But in this case, the case we are going to discuss today, here the agent doesn't know about the model. It doesn't know if it applies a particular action, where will it be in the next time step. So it has to try things, it has to try different things in the environment, and then it has to learn something from which it can update the policy. So this can be done using something called Monte Carlo approach. So in Monte Carlo approach that we are going to discuss in this video, we will discuss a particular variant of Monte Carlo approach called exploring start. So let's go to the slides and let's see how this algorithm works, and later after learning about the algorithm, we'll show a small example of a grid navigation by an agent to reach a particular goal, and we'll understand how this algorithm is implemented in reality.
So here is the algorithm. So before starting the algorithm, we have to assign arbitrary Q values for every state action pairs. So I hope you remember what is Q values. When we apply a particular action in a state and then onwards we apply that particular policy. Okay, so it is the expected return we get after applying that particular action in that particular state. So it's the Q value for that particular state action pair. Okay, so we have to assign arbitrary values for it. Okay, and also we have to assign a arbitrary policy. Then what we do, we choose a random state action pair from all the state action pairs we have and generate an episode starting from that state and applying that particular action, and then onwards applying the policy. So here in the example, you can see we selected this state S1 and action A1. So we selected this state action pair and we apply the action A1 in state S1, and we are here now. And then onwards we apply the policy. You can see the policy. I have drawn the policy in blue. These are the policies, left, right, up, down. These are the policies. So for this state, if you're in this state, the policy says go towards right. So once we are here in the state, after applying the first action A1, here in this state, then we follow the policy. We have to go here, and from here we go here, then up and up, and then here right, down, right, down, 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 and left. Okay, we execute the policy for a fixed number of steps and we are here. So once we are at the end of the policy, after we execute the policy for a fixed number of steps, what we do for each state action pair we see in the environment. For example, in this state, in this particular state, we see the action up. So this is a state action pair, right? For each state action pair we see in the environment for this particular episode, we need to compute the return. So for this state, return will be how much? So we'll add all the rewards. So I forgot to tell you that for every single state, we give negative. Let's for example, for this particular example, we give negative reward for every single state until and unless we reach this goal state. For goal state, let's say we give reward of 1000. Okay. So we have to add all the rewards from this state onwards if we have to compute the return for this particular state action pair. Okay. Similarly, if we have to compute the state, we have to compute the return for this state action pair. The state is this grid box and the action is this down. And then when we have to compute the return, we have to add all the reward it sees after this state action pair. Okay, from here to here. So minus one, minus one, minus one, minus one, like this. So we compute the return for every single state action pair like this. So we create a list actually for every single state action pair and we add the return to the list. For every single state action pair, we add the return to the list. Okay, then since this is an iterative algorithm, we repeat this. We can do it for once actually. We can keep only one value here, the return value here, or we can repeat it multiple times, like starting from different starting point, like state action pair, and executing a policy from here and accordingly computing the returns for every single state action pairs. After doing this loop, you can do it for one or you can do it for multiple times. We go to the next step. We update the Q values for the state action pairs. So to compute the Q values for state action pairs, what we have to do, we just have to take the average of the particular list. So to compute the Q value for this particular state action pair S0 and A0, we have to take the average of the return that we have stored in the list assigned for S0 and A0 pair. Okay, similarly, we compute the Q values for all other state action pairs. Once we have these new Q values, so initially we had arbitrary values, right? So we updated the Q values now. We put the average of the list. So after this, we have to update the policy. So we update the policy greedily. That is, for every state we see during our episodes, we update the policy like this. So now policy will return the action that maximizes this Q value. Now we have this new policy, right? So we go back and repeat this again. We choose a random state action pair. We have now new policy. So starting from the state action pair, we execute an episode, and for each state action pair that we see in the episode, we add the return in the list, the respective list, and then what do we do? Then we update our Q values like this. We take the average of the respective list, and that is the new Q values. That is the estimation of the new Q values actually, and then we update the policy greedily again. Our policy now should return the action that maximizes the Q value for a particular state. That's all, and this loop has to be repeated again and again until we have this convergence. Convergence means we are not getting any new policy. We are not anymore updating the values in the policy. It's static. Till that time, we have to repeat it. And after this convergence, after this convergence, we'll have a policy, the optimal policy. So that's it. So let's see an example of this algorithm now. We'll show a grid world navigation example, very simple example. And I have designed the example such that, and I set the initial policy and I set the initial Q values and everything such that it finds the optimal policy in one or two steps. So that because it's manual computation, so I want to show you in few steps. So here it is. Okay, so this is our example. Okay, here is our agent. It's a smiley, basically. And it has to start from this. This is a starting point, okay? So actually starting point doesn't matter. We need to find a policy so that from any point, any state in this environment, the agent knows how to reach the goal in minimum number of steps. So now this is our environment, okay? And I have this policy. So you see the state IDs here. And these are the state action pairs. So for state A, we can go up, we can go down maybe, but there is no down anyways. For state B, we can go up, we can go down. For state C, we can go right or we can go down like this. So we have these state action pairs, okay? And let's see the rewards. For all the states from A, B, C, D, E, F, and G, we'll get -1, and if we are in state H, we'll get +100. Now we set an arbitrary policy. So if you're in state A, you have to go up. If you're in state B, you have to go up. In C, right, E up, D down, F down, G down. And if you're in state H, then it's done. You have you are in the goal position, so you don't have to do anything. So here is the initial policy. So it is not optimal policy because if you start from A, you go to B, you go to C, you go to E, then from E you go up and D go down and you go up. So you are in a loop in this in these two states. So it's not optimal policy. You are going here and you are forever stuck here. So it's not an optimal policy. You will never be able to reach H if you start from A, but if you start from F, you will reach. So for all the states, it's not optimal. Okay. So what we have to do like this. So we select a random state action pair. So we select C and we the action is down. So we select a random state action pair. State is C, action is down. So we execute it first. So we executed the first action. So we executed this state action pair. Okay. After executing this state action pair, we have to execute the policy. And here in this case, this is our initial policy. So we will execute that policy for a few number of steps. So yeah, we executed that policy and we are in state D now. So we compute the return for every single state action pair we have observed in this trajectory. So first we observe the our first state action. This is C and down. We are here. We went like this. So this is the first one. So we computed the return and this is the discount factor. So we got this return for C down. Okay, state action pair. So for B up, so from B we went up. So for B up, we computed the return like this. For C right, we computed the return, and for E up, for E, from E we went up. So for this we get only -1. Okay, we have this state action pair now. We inserted these state action pairs in the list, the corresponding list. Okay, we created a list like this, and then we select another state action pair. Okay, this time we let's say we selected E right. Okay, we execute the initial action now. Okay, you executed the initial action. Now you have to follow the policy. What is the policy? From F, we have to go down. Okay. From F, we are going down. From G, we are going down and we are done. We have executed the policy. Now we will update the returns in the corresponding lists. So we updated. So for E right, we computed and we got this value. So here it is -1, -1, -1. Multiplied accordingly with the discount factors. And then at the end, we get the reward of 100. So overall, we get 98.2. Okay, here. So here for F, we computed this. For G, we computed this. For G, it is 100 because it is obvious. From G, we are here in H. And we are not multiplying with discount factor because discount factor is 0 here, 1 here. We got 100. Okay, and we probably had these previous values, right? C down, we already computed. These are the new states we saw for the first time. State action pairs we saw for the first time. Okay, then again, we selected a new state action pair. It is B and B up. We are taking B up. So we from B, we'll go up and then we'll execute the policy, our policy. So from C, we'll go like this. Okay, so now we'll again compute our returns. Okay, so here we already had this C where we computed the returns, and if we have already seen that state action pair, then we simply append the return here. So we appended the return, we inserted the return at the end, like this, like this. Okay, we have done three iterations to compute the Q values. You can do one iteration also, but I just showed it for three times. And from here, we estimate the Q values for this state action pairs that we have seen so far. So how we will compute the Q values, like estimation of the Q values, we just take the average of these values, okay? So we update the Q values. So we took the average of those lists, okay? So we have these Q values now. Now we have to update the policy. Okay, so here you see, we set the action that maximizes the Q value. Okay, so here we are updating E, because for E right, because for, if you see E up, it's minus 1.4. And for E right, it's 98.2. For E left, we assume some value like 0. Because it's the initial value and we don't have any value here, so it's let's say it's 0. And so we have to update the policy now for E only, because for other values it's okay, like it is optimal already. Yeah, if you check, you get optimal values, like maximum values for these state action pairs. Okay, so we are going to update E to right. So we updated E to right. Okay, now we are done. So we have this optimal policy, because if you try multiple times, like if you try even more, like starting from different state action pairs, this policy shouldn't say change much, but this is the optimal policy actually. So it is obvious, you can see it is optimal. Okay, so now we have this new policy. Okay, now we can test the agent, how it moves. So it is moving directly. And this is the minimum number of states steps you can it can have.
So so in this video we have learned about Monte Carlo method for reinforcement learning, and in particular we learned about something called exploring start. So exploring start is not very useful, because for many robots, let's say for many systems, you cannot set it in a particular state. Let's take an example for a robot that moves in the environment, let's say move in terrain. So you cannot set it in arbitrary position. It cannot set itself in different initial states. Okay, so to avoid this, we have other approaches. So we'll learn about it in our upcoming videos. So if you like this video, don't forget to subscribe it. Subscribe to my channel, and don't forget to like the video, and don't forget to click the bell icon so that you get the notification when I upload the next videos. So see you next time. Bye bye.